It's finally moving day, which is, it's a hassle, but it's also a good thing. Moving for me is always an opportunity to downsize, to get rid of all the things that I've collected, the stuff that's just amassed on my desk, on my shelves, over time, and just pare it down to what I actually really need. Conservation tip from my dad: when your socks get old and get holes in them, don't just throw them away. They make good rags. Morning. Welcome to the next day. I spent the whole day moving, kind of setting up some stuff, sort of unpacking, and then I spent the whole night doing the math for what we're about to go over. I figured it would probably be best just to wait until the morning so I could record with some decent lighting, because I don't have a good lighting set up here yet. So this is going to be one of those episodes that's really heavy on information and sort of light on the cinematics and editing. In fact, you've seen all of that already. So as you already know from the title of this video, we are going over the best attackers since the Gen 2 update. Before we start, I have to give credit to Professor Kukui for originally creating the spreadsheet that I used as a base, and then to iNoNo22 on Reddit, who updated Professor Kukui's spreadsheet with all Gen 2 moves, movesets, and Pokemon. From there, I took that spreadsheet because I don't generally like the way that the DPS rankings are calculated, and I did my own math on it. Also, sorry, I know it's kind of like echo in here, but that'll get better as everything gets set up, I promise. Just to refresh you on how I calculate my DPS rankings, I calculate the damage a Pokemon will deal with its basic attack, its quick attack, and its charge attack against a Pokemon with the average defense stat, that's 150. Then I calculate how many quick attacks it needs to use to fill up one bar of its charge attack, and I count those quick attacks plus one charge attack as a full cycle. Then from there, the calculation is simple. I find out the amount of time it takes for that Pokemon to use a full cycle of moves, and then calculate the DPS from there. So these rankings are based on the damage per second that each Pokemon deals over one cycle of quick moves and one charge attack. In many cases, movesets with charge attacks that have more than one charge bar will actually perform slightly better in their real-world performance, because the Pokemon is going to be able to get to that maximum DPS faster. So for example, if you have to use 7 quick attacks to fill up one bar of a 3-bar charge move, but it takes 18 quick attacks to fill up a charge bar for a 1-bar charge move, you'll be using your charge moves a lot quicker and a lot more frequently in the case of multiple charge bars, which means the multiple charge bar Pokemon will be using its charge move while the single charge bar Pokemon is still using quick attacks, because most Pokemon really rely on that charge move to bring up the overall DPS of the full cycle. Of course, I am going to put links to my spreadsheet in the description, but throughout the course of this video, I'll explain how you can sort of use it and what everything means. We'll start with attackers. This is just offensive DPS. These are the Pokemon who are going to deal the most damage the fastest. Also, I'm sorry if there's construction noise. That'll probably be going on for a while. To sort Pokemon offensively, you're going to want to go to offensive percentage and sort that Z to A. And that's going to show you all the Pokemon who are going to deal the most damage the fastest. So the new strongest Pokemon, the Pokemon with the highest damage per second in Pokemon Go, is Gengar with Hex and Shadow Ball. Again, the strongest Pokemon is going to have 100% as its rating, and then every Pokemon under that is going to have a percentage that compares their DPS with that moveset to the best overall DPS, in this case, Gengar with Hex and Shadow Ball. A close second is Gengar with Hex and Focus Blast, which actually makes me feel a lot better about getting that moveset on mine. And that's actually going to be one of the best non-fighting type Pokemon to counter Blissey, especially a Blissey with Pound and Hyper Beam, because Gengar is going to resist those attacks. Third place is a legacy moveset, Dragonite with Dragon Breath and Hyper Beam. Pokemon with legacy movesets are going to be italicized, so the name, the basic, and the charge attack will all be italicized if it's a legacy moveset. And just a quick word on that, I think part of the reason that Niantic decided to make some of these really strong movesets legacy is because it gives things more trade value for when trading comes out. It seems like there are two camps when it comes to trading. People who think it's going to break the game, and people who think it's worthless. Well, when Niantic makes changes like this that make certain types of Pokemon, certain movesets, unobtainable, that adds immense trade value to those Pokemon. And it actually gives me a reason to try to trade for another Dragonite. Even though I have one for my Pokedex already, I can't get one with Dragon Breath anymore. Moving on, more Gengar movesets, more Dragonites with Dragon Breath, and then we come to Machamp with Counter and Dynamic Punch. That differs from what I said in the video yesterday, where I said Counter and Close Combat was going to be Machamp's best moveset. But you saw that Counter and Close Combat actually did a decent job taking down a Blissey with higher CP than my Machamp. And if we scroll down, you can see Counter Close Combat Machamp comes in at 83%, this Machamp here, 89%. So not a huge difference, but obviously this one is going to be better overall. Dynamic Punch is also a 2-bar charge move, meaning you'll get to that maximum DPS faster. So in most cases, well, in all cases really, it's going to be the better moveset. After that, we have Alakazam with Psycho Cut and Shadow Ball. So even though on the surface, Psycho Cut's damage got nerfed quite a bit, it actually charges energy very quickly, making it still a decent choice, actually the best choice, for Alakazam. Below that, we have a Gengar Legacy moveset, Shadow Claw Shadow Ball, Alakazam with Confusion Shadow Ball, which I think is what my perfect IV Alakazam has. And then we get to Charizard with its new best moveset, Air Slash and Overheat. We have Flareon with Fire Spin and Overheat, more Alakazam movesets, Psycho Cut Dazzling Gleam, Psycho Cut Focus Blast, then we get to Machamp with Counter and Heavy Slam. Moving down the list, more Gengar, more Alakazam, then we come to Heracross with Counter and Close Combat, which matches Machamp with Counter and Close Combat equally because they have the same attack stat. After that, Heracross with Counter and Earthquake, more Alakazam, and then finally Tyranitar with Bite and Fire Blast. Arcanine's new best moveset, Fire Fang and Wild Charge, surprisingly. Heracross with Counter and Mega Horn. So it's a lot of the same Pokemon at the top. And then once we get down to about 70, into the 70s, below 80% of the DPS of the best moveset, we start to see a little bit more diversity. Haunter is actually up here with Astonish and Sludge Bomb. Haunter, a Pokemon that's not even fully evolved, is dealing a lot more damage than so many other Pokemon. Same goes for Kadabra here with Confusion and Shadow Ball. But above that, we have Tyranitar with Bite and Crunch, which is going to be the best Dark-type attacker. Exeggutor's new best moveset, Extra Sensory and Solar Beam. There's Espeon with Zen Headbutt and Future Sight, and very close behind is Confusion and Future Sight. But remember, all these calculations are done against a Pokemon with the average defense, and as that defense stat changes, these moves could move around slightly. Because of the way the game rounds damage in the damage formula, even a change of one base defense could make one move jump above the other for a short time. And by short time, I mean for a range. So, for example, these calculations are done at 150 base defense, but because of the way the game rounds, from 151 to 160 base defense, things could change, and then change back, and then change, and then change back. So it's always going to be important to look at the percentages to see exactly how much difference there is between a Pokemon's movesets. So if you want to do that, if you want to look at how much difference there is between a Pokemon's offensive movesets, first sort Z to A on offense, and then sort A to Z, or Z to A, on the name. And that'll organize the spreadsheet by Pokemon's name. So now you have all of Alakazam's movesets right here, organized by their offensive percentage. Psycho Cut Shadow Ball, Confusion Shadow Ball, Psycho Cut Dazzling Gleam, all the way down, unfortunately, to Confusion Psychic and Psycho Cut Psychic, which is the sad part, really, because a lot of people put Stardust into that moveset. So I'll let you guys look through the rest of the list on your own time, but for now, we're going to go to dual percentage. We sort Z to A here, and these are overall the best Pokemon in battle. Dual percentage is calculated by multiplying a Pokemon's full cycle DPS against its tankiness, which is its HP stat, times its defense stat, which gives you its basically its defensive capabilities. And at the very top, we have 5 Blissey movesets. Dual percentage basically tells you how well this Pokemon is going to do if you go into battle and just spam its attacks and you don't dodge at all. And if you send a Blissey in as an attacker, just use Pound and Hyper Beam and don't dodge at all. If you're the same level as the other Pokemon, this Blissey should win every time. Now remember, it's not going to do it quickly, because if you look at offensive percentage, It's 41%, meaning it's nowhere near the top DPS Pokemon. But because Blissey has so much HP, it's gonna survive way longer than any other Pokemon, and over the course of its lifetime, it's gonna deal a lot more damage. So yeah, Blissey is definitely broken. If you have the time and the potions, Blissey is the best Pokemon to use in any battle, provided you're not gonna time out with it. Will it get a nerf? Not a specific targeted nerf, but I think Niantic could make use of the HP constant that I suggested for the HP formula months ago, really. With an HP constant, Blissey would still be the strongest, Blissey would still be the best, but it would bring a lot of other Pokemon much closer to it so that there isn't as much of a gap between Blissey and, say, even the strongest Tyranitar at 71%. So beyond Blissey, we have Dragonite, again, a legacy moveset, Dragon Breath Hyper Beam, coming in at 72%. Tyranitar, like I said, 71%. Tyranitar Bite and Crunch, 68%. More Dragonites, more Tyranitars. Then we get to Vaporeon, still a top-tier Pokemon, but it comes in at 63% compared to Blissey. Dragonite with Dragon Tail and Outrage, which is a new moveset, is pretty close to the top. So that's good news for people who missed out on Dragon Breath. Snorlax with Zen Headbutt Hyper Beam is right up here. More Dragonites, more Vaporeons, more Snorlax, which is all stuff that we've seen before. But Machamp, with Counter and Dynamic Punch, has actually made it into the top 10 Pokemon here. Not top 10 movesets, but top 10 different Pokemon. Rhydon still up here. Donphan is a new entry with Counter and Play Rough. Heracross is also new with Counter and Close Combat or Earthquake. There's a Steel Wing Dragonite up here, a legacy moveset Gyarados, Super Legacy, couldn't get this one since August. Lapras with its new best quick move, Water Gun. More Donphan, Dragonite, Machamp, a lot of the same Pokemon up here. And at this point, we're already down to 50% of Blissey's overall efficiency in battle. That doesn't mean these Pokemon are bad, because a lot of them are going to deal damage faster than Blissey and get you through battles a lot quicker. But again, Blissey is just that much stronger than everything else in terms of survivability versus damage. Again, once you're sorted by dual percentage, you can sort by name to see each Pokemon's best movesets in terms of dual ability. So looking at Blissey, well, there they are. You saw them all at the top anyway. You have Charizard here, sorted by dual ability. Anyway, let's go back to dual here. There's also defensive rankings here, which you can definitely use, but again, we're gonna be going over this in a separate video to sort of talk about the defensive metagame. As it stands right now, Blissey is the best Pokemon to put in gyms because along with its huge defensive stats, it deals a fair amount of damage over the course of its life and has higher CP than so many other Pokemon. Again, you have things like Dragonite and Tyranitar up here, but you have to consider their weaknesses. They both have double weaknesses, which means they should actually be lower on the defensive tier list than this calculation places them. But like I said, we'll go into detail on that in a future video. There's another tab down here called Showing Work, which shows all the numbers, all the calculations. So if you're interested in looking at that and seeing how much damage each Pokemon is actually dealing, what its DPS is for its quick move, for its charge move, all that is here on the Showing Work tab. And if you want to use a spreadsheet to do your own calculations, this is the place to do it because it has all the stats set up here for you to calculate things however you like. I do want to go back here and just make a note. If you want to see legendary Pokemon included, just go to this column that says legendary and check yes, and that'll add all the legendary Pokemon. So if we sort offensively, you can see that Mewtwo is actually going to be better than Gengar whenever we do finally see him. Not going to be here for a while, but it's there. In case they do come out, I won't have to update this spreadsheet. So now, with all that gone over, first I'm going to hatch an egg, but then I'm going to evolve some more Pokemon and see if I can get some of these better new movesets. Is that new? No. This is just a slow connection. Just out of curiosity, where does Dewgong rank now? Remember, you can always search with Command F or Control F, or you can filter by name. If you clear everything, search for only the Pokemon you're looking for, and check it there, it'll show you only that Pokemon's movesets. So Dewgong, unfortunately, comes in at 26% on its dual percentage, and that's with the legacy moveset, which fortunately I have, but it's really not even that great compared to the next available moveset, Frost Breath and Blizzard. The main thing I want to evolve here is a Machoke, because I have enough candies to do one more, I did get a Machamp with counter in close combat yesterday, but counter and dynamic punch is going to be a little bit better, so maybe I can get it. And like I said, it has two charge bars, which makes it a little bit more efficient in faster battles. And sort of overall, because you don't ever waste time charging extra energy. If you have a two-bar charge move, you'll just start filling up that second bar while you're waiting for an opportunity to get two steel-type moves. Bummer. Machamp, Bullet Punch, Heavy Slam. Well, it's like fifth out of its currently obtainable movesets. I'd like to compare that to other steel attackers. I know Scissor is probably going to be the best, but I'll do that in another video coming up soon. We'll go over the best attackers of each type. So if you're looking for a specific type advantage, type matchup, you'll know which Pokemon are going to be the best for that. So my perfect IV, Crobat. It got Air Slash and Air Cutter. Third best moveset, unfortunately, not the best. And third best by about 10% difference from Air Slash and Shadow Ball. It is two moves of the same type. So just to show you this, in case you're interested in doing it, if you go to Showing Work, right now, the spreadsheet only accounts for Stab, if the Pokemon's moves are going to benefit from Stab. But if we look for Find Crobat, and here you have all of Crobat's movesets with all of their different damage. So you're going to want to scroll over to Charge Move here, and Charge Damage. You can edit the formula. I know this is probably intense. This is a little more than a lot of people are going to want to do. But if you want to add in super effective damage, just right here, before the plus one, add a times 1.25. That's going to be super effective damage. That will update everything. So if you come over here and look at offensive percentage now, no, dual percentage is what I was looking at. You can see that there's a little bit less of a gap when both of those moves are going to be super effective. Of course, I didn't update the quick moves to be super effective, but they're still going to deal a relatively similar amount of damage. Their damage is going to scale equally with super effectiveness, whereas in this case, Air Cutter is only going to be super effective, whereas Shadow Ball and Sludge Bomb are not. So if you do want to check how well a moveset of the same type is going to compare to the best overall moveset, that's how you're going to do it. So again, I'm going to put a link to this spreadsheet in the description. It'll be a link to add a copy to your own Google Drive, so that way you can make all the edits you want to make without changing it for anyone else. So when you click that link, it's going to ask you to add a copy to your Google Drive, and then you can open it with your own Google account. So that's going to be it for this one. Check out the spreadsheet. If you have any questions, please ask. And we'll be going over defensive rankings, or sort of a tier list, which depends on more than just DPS, in the future. For now though, check all your legacy movesets so you can know which Pokemon to transfer. And yes, it's possible that Niantic will make changes to moves again, but I wouldn't just start hoarding Pokemon just in case, because you'll probably run out of space really quickly. So anyway, I gotta start editing, and then I have a lot more work to do here, getting this apartment livable. See you guys tomorrow.